The metric system is universally used within the sciences. However, some students really struggle with understanding how the metric system relates to scientific notation. In this short tutorial, we'll discuss metric prefixes and show how they can also be represented by both decimal numbers and powers of 10. Let's begin with the metric staircase, which is a visual way of understanding the metric system. This area here in the center of the staircase is what's known as the base unit. If you're measuring length, this unit would be meters. If you're measuring volume, it would be liters. And if you're measuring mass, this would be grams. For this animation, we'll just go ahead and work with meters. Notice that each step has a specific prefix. Each of these prefixes can be associated with a specific number. For example, the prefix deca means 10. So a decameter will be equal to 10 meters. As you move up the metric staircase, length measurements increase by factors of 10. The prefix hecto means 100. So a hectometer would be equal to 100 meters. Kilo means 1,000. So a kilometer is equal to 1,000 meters. The prefix mega means million. So a megameter is a million meters, and a gigameter is equal to a billion meters. Now, as you can see, these numbers can start to get really big. So scientists have come up with a shortened form to represent both the metric prefix and the number. This involves scientific notation, or in this case, what's referred to as powers of 10. For example, we already know that the prefix deca means 10. The scientific notation for 10 is 10 to the first power, which is written like this. The prefix hecto means 100, or 10 to the second power. Kilo means 1,000, or 10 to the third power. Now pay attention when we get to mega, because mega is not 10 to the fourth power. It's 10 to the sixth power. We've skipped a few powers of 10. Not every power of 10 has a metric prefix associated with it. So that's important to know as you move up the staircase. Giga, which means billion, can be referred to as 10 to the ninth power. So how do you keep all these powers of 10 straight and know which decimal numbers they actually represent? Well, the secret lies in keeping track of your decimal point. Let's go back to the base metric unit, which is always represented as 10 to the 0 power, or simply 1.0. Notice where the decimal point is. Now, whenever you see a number with a power next to it, that's how many spaces to the right you move the decimal point. Take deca, for instance. Deca is 10 to the first power. So you start with a base unit of 1.0, and then move the decimal point one space to the right. So 10 to the first power is equal to 10. Let's try mega. Mega is 10 to the sixth power. So start with your base of 1.0 and then move the decimal point six spaces to the right. So 10 to the sixth is equal to 1 million. Let's return to the base measurement of 10 to the zero, or 1.0 meters, and then start moving down the metric staircase. Notice that as you move down the staircase, measurements decrease by factors of 10. For example, the prefix deci means 1/10, or 10 to the negative first power. When you see that negative power, that simply means you need to move the decimal point to the left instead of to the right. So if you start with your base unit of 1.0 and move the decimal point one space to the left, you end up with 0.1. which is the same as 1/10. Let's move on to centi. Centi means 1/100th, or 10 to the negative 2. Milli means 1,000th, or 10 to the negative 3. Okay, now we skip a few powers of 10 and move on to micro, which is 10 to the negative 6, or 1/1,000,000th, and nano, which is 10 to the negative 9, or 1/1,000,000,000th. Let's do a quick recap of what we've covered so far. Remember that as you move up the metric staircase, measurements increase by factors of 10. And as you move down the metric staircase, measurements decrease by factors of 10. The power of 10 tells you how many places to move the decimal point. A positive power tells you to move the decimal point to the right, while a negative power means to move the decimal point to the left.